Hi, it's Dre Griggs of Obsidian Wisdom. Today I'll share with you my retirement planning guidebook for families to make sure that when you retire, you stay retired, that you enjoy your retirement, and that you have peace of mind. When I talk to my clients and we talk about retirement, why it's important, how do I make sure that I enjoy mine, most of the time I'm usually saying, hey, what is the most important part of retirement? And most people will say happiness or our health, or we want to make sure our family is okay. We want to make sure we have enough money. There's so much that goes into a retirement to make sure it's successful that that's often why you hear me say it's more than riches. That is true about all aspects of life. The success of your family, it's about more than riches. Your retirement is more than riches. Whether you enjoy your job is more than riches. Whether you have a plan, it's not always about the money. Now, the money is important, and we're going to talk a lot about it, but we have to put it in the right context. Our goal is not to get the money. Our goal is to be able to use the money to build comfort, to build the freedom, to build the flexibility, so we can then do the things we want to enjoy. That sometimes we're willing to sacrifice some things that maybe we wouldn't if we really thought about it. It reminds me of the story of the fisherman and the businessman. And there was this fisherman, he would wake up at 5 in the morning, he would go fish for about 4 hours, so it's about 9 o'clock when he's done, and then he goes home. The businessman noticed that he kept doing that. Now, granted, every time the businessman saw the fisherman's boat, he always noticed that it was full of fish. And he just really was trying to figure out why the guy doesn't fish all day, because if he fished all day, he can have so much more money. And so one day, the businessman went up to the fisherman, and he said, hey, I've noticed that you stopped fishing around 9 a.m., can I ask you why? The fisherman was like, sure. I normally like to get home around 9, 9:30 because it's important for me to have breakfast with my wife. And then I often see my kids off to school, and that's often something that I also cherish and I enjoy doing. And then I go into town around noon, 1 o'clock, and I usually catch up with old friends. We have a couple drinks, we catch up on old times, we share great stories. When my kids come home, I'm there to be able to hang out with them. And then I usually spend the evening, we play like board games and we just have fun in general. But I like to spend time with my family, my friends, and just enjoying myself. And then the businessman asked the fisherman, have you ever considered fishing all day? And the fisherman looked and he said, I haven't. And he said, why would I do that? He said, well, if you fished all day, then instead of getting one boatload of fish, you would have 6 boatloads. And then you could expand your business. And he said, well, why would I want to do that? And he said, once you expand your business, you can hire multiple people, and then you can make a ton of money. And then the fisherman is like, okay, and then why would I want to do that? And he's like, well, once you have all the money, then you're able to have the freedom to kind of live your life exactly how you want. And once you have all that money, then you're able to cut back to fishing only from like 5 to 9 a.m., and then you can have breakfast with your wife, see your kids off to school, hang out with your friends and catch up on old times, and then you can even be at home and hang out with your family early each afternoon. And the fisherman looked at him and he said, that's exactly what I have right now. And the businessman looked at him and he said, yeah, you're right. See, oftentimes we think that we have to have all of this money to be able to live a certain life. But the reality is, most of the things that we would cherish in life, we can actually do that today. And it's important to be able to have that shift, because the reason that most of us have difficulty spending money is because we know what it costs us to get the money. We know that a $10,000 trip, well, that's really expensive because, you know, that's 3 months of my salary, that's 4 months of my salary, I don't know how many months, 1 month of your salary. You would say, well, I don't want to do that because that's such a long amount of time. Like, how could I trade 1 month of my life for 1 day of some sort of a vacation? But if you're able to separate your money from your time, and you saw the time as just what you do with yourself each day, well, then you're able to say, well, I can spend the money because the money isn't really that important. My happiness, I've tied so many things up already. Now, granted, there are expenses. You are going to need to be able to have the money to afford certain things in life, but money is about comfort, not about happiness. The happiness, that comes from what we do each day. And Happiness by Design, it's a great book, and it talks about that. It said, look, at the end of the day, you're going to be happy from pleasure and purpose. How much of your time each day do you spend on pleasure versus how much of your time do you spend each day on purpose? If you have the right balance, then you're going to be happy.